Good afternoon. This is Dr. Elizabeth Vanacore from the Puerto Rico Seismic Network coming to you live on the afternoon of January 3rd, 2020 to give you an update on the current seismic activity in the Puerto Rico region. Currently, as of today, the last few days, we have recorded about 1,800 events across the entire Puerto Rico and Virgin Islands region. So this is important to note that it is not only the events in the southwestern part of Puerto Rico, but we also have events in septentrional fault, a small swarm, which is consistent with normal activity in the region, as well as a continuation of the aftershock sequence from the 6.0 we had in September. Otherwise, I want to concentrate a bit more on the activity going down in the southwestern Puerto Rico, as this is of interest to the public. All right. In southwestern Puerto Rico, we have currently detected a number of events. We had a small swarm in around Caja de Muertos, but however, we have the main events have occurred in southwestern Puerto Rico. This area is near the Punta Montalva Fault, as well as the Guanajuato Canyon. In this region, we have, so far in our catalog, we have added 717 events in the general. Of those events, 622 have been associated with the seismic sequence. This seismic sequence is associated with a 4.7 precursor, which happened on the 28th of December, with a main shock happening a few hours later on as the magnitude 5.0. Important to note, if this is a zoom in of the hours after the aftershocks, that we have a general cloud occurring in the southwest. This is because we use a 1D model to locate earthquakes. In order to determine if it is the Punta Montalva Fault or the Guanajuato Canyon, this will require future work by scientists here in the Puerto Rico Seismic Network, as well as the University of Puerto Rico Mayagüez, to determine better locations as well as focal mechanisms, or how the fault ruptured, and determine if it was the Punta Montalva, Guanajuato Canyon, or both, or another unknown fault in the region. And with the aftershocks have a general behavior that is observed by seismologists. In seismology, we have a main shock, such as the 5.0, and then we have a series of aftershocks. In general, the frequency of these aftershocks decrease with the reciprocal of time. This means that on day one of the aftershocks, you'll have 10 times as many earthquakes as day 10. So we should see a decrease in activity over time. Notice I did say frequency, not magnitude. So you can still have significant magnitudes in these earthquake aftershock sequences. And an event like the one we had last night, such as the 4.7, will temporarily re-energize the system. With the system, it is possible, given the location, which is near land and near towns, and the depth, which is tends to be less than 10 kilometers, a number of the events will be felt by the public. So the public can expect to feel more events in the near future. And if you feel an event, to please report it to the Puerto Rico Seismic Network. As I was mentioning, the Punta Montalva Fault, this is a relatively new fault in our records, which I've generally put onto this slide here as the red line. And you can see this is the on land expression of it, and it may continue out into the region that we're currently seeing the activity. What I've plotted here to clean up the cloud a bit is only events of magnitude 2.5 or greater. So one of the questions that might be coming into mind is, why are there so many events in this aftershock sequence? Part of that answer is, the Puerto Rico Seismic Network has a number of stations that are permanent in the southwest, and therefore we detect lower magnitudes. So this is showing here is the magnitude versus time. And each one of these points is an individual event located by our analysts here in the Puerto Rico Seismic Network. This is good as of 9:30 this morning. What you can see is when you have the five, you have a number of aftershocks that occur afterwards. And you can see we're getting down to magnitudes about 1 to 1.2 in completeness. Below that, where I put the red box, we do not have the capacity to detect those earthquakes. In comparison, we look at the aftershock sequence of the 6.2. or sorry, the 6.0 of September, you actually have a magnitude complaints of about 2.5. So the part of the reason we're seeing more earthquakes is that our instruments can see it better because it's close to land and close to our instrumentation. This, of course, means that people also will feel the events. One thing to note, that every single one of these earthquakes are manually reviewed by our analysts here in the Puerto Rico Seismic Network. All of our analysts have been working extra hours in order to locate as many of these events as quickly as possible. Of course, the priority is the larger events, so that's why in later times you see our magnitude 2 and greater seems much more complete. And we are in the process of locating all the smaller events, of which we have about 600 or so left to locate. So each one of these are being worked on quite rapidly by every single one of our analysts over time. Remember, our analysts are human and are experiencing this event just as much as the public, and we are doing as much as we can as soon as we can. Remember, one thing about earthquakes is the only thing predictable about an earthquake is that it's unpredictable. Given that, what can you do as a public? You can prepare. So for information of how to prepare, look at the resources available on the Puerto Rico Seismic Network website or the State Emergency Management website, where there are instructions on how to generate your family plan, as well as prepare your emergency backpack. Thank you. Have a good night.